This is a disclaimer for the video and the material I'm getting ready to use. Shalom, shalom. This is Kapaya, aka Pops, out of GMS Chicago, with another sit down. Before I get started, though, like always, I want to send all praises, honor, and glory out to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rekah Kodash. To the apostles and elders of GMS out of New York, I'm going to send up honors because they do real well. For the brethren around the world, pushing this truth uncut, unfiltered, giving you the good, the bad, and ugly of the scriptures, correctly breaking down the prophecies and interaction. To the people on the planet, declaring warning, that's in salutations. For the hope we like, the hope this is edifying. For the Aquaf, the pure and the true, as listen to say in the charity, keep doing so. But for the scorn of scoff, we reprobate truth, there are Israelites and 17 other nations who are in the midst of Jacob's trouble. It's only going to get worse. I see this lesson here, and I'm going to get a look at it, but what I opened it up to go look at it, and it was kind of ironic. And the reason I say that is because of the fact that, you know, I had a situation happen where one of the guys that I work with said, I know you don't do these so-called holidays and this, that, and the other, and blah, 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 blah. And I told him, no, you're right. I said, because if you think about it, I said, if you saying a happy Thanksgiving to one of the natives that was here when the so-called pilgrims got here, and that whole scenario, that would be like somebody saying to you, happy slavery, nigga, you know, even if in modern times, it would be like if somebody said to you right now, happy slavery, nigga. And, you know, he bucked his eyes and damn. But then he was able to wrap his mind around it and say, you know what, though? You're right. Same thing with a female. Hold on. So, like I was saying, you know. Yeah, so like I was saying, you know. So, you know, these Israelite women are so fucking devoid of their heritage and their history that all they want to do is go around here and celebrate Turkey Day and all this other kind of shit. And sing, it's talking about Happy Thanksgiving and how was your Thanksgiving? And like I said, the brother, when I said to him, when I brought that to him, he said, you saying that is like saying to one of the natives, you saying Happy Thanksgiving would be like a native saying to you, happy slavery, nigga. Okay? So, that being the case, I mean, and it caught him off guard. He bucked his eyes. He thought about it. He blinked. All that shit. Because he know that I don't fuck with, the holidays, like he said, or whatnot. These fucking abominable ass days that Esau want to put up his holiday. But once he wrapped his mind around it, he was like, damn, you know, it didn't take him long. He was able to stand right here, you know, and get it. Didn't take him long. But I said that shit to a female, a nigga woman. And all she could respond to with was, don't blow my vibe. Please don't blow my vibe. I'm like, wow. They don't want to hear it. So the scripture that comes to mind with that is this one. Yeah, well, actually, I can go back there. It said, come to pass, and the land says, Yahweh, two parts then shall be cut off and die, but the third part then shall be left therein. That's why two thirds gotta die. That's why they gotta die. Because they can have so much compassion about so much stuff, but can't remember their own history and what absolutely did happen to them. Okay? And even when it's brought up to them, they want to push it under the rug. So that brings this scripture to mind. Woe to the rebellious children, says Jehovah, that take counsel, but not of me, and that cover with a covering, but not of my spirit, that they may add sin to sin. So they want to add sin to sin. Do something abominable, wake up and eat something abominable, and think something abominable. And then say that they believe in Yahweh. How can you believe when you call him the Lord and you call his son Jesus Christ? How do you believe? You don't even have the truth, so you don't know what you believe. So, you know, but this isn't meant to be a long one. Because that's what I said, you know, it was just so ironic. Just so ironic that of all the things that could be said, please don't blow my vibe.
Don't kill my vibe, bitch, don't kill my vibe. I can feel your energy from two planets away. I got my drink, I got my music, I will share if I did it. Bitch, don't kill my vibe, bitch, don't kill my vibe. Bitch, don't kill my vibe, bitch, don't kill my vibe.
I'm trying to keep it alive and I can't.